Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lee Meriwether, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reilly.
Johnny Olsen, how are you? Splendid. You think they caught that maneuver on camera? Flipping the Kleenex box, the back flip to the Kleenex box. I have a cold. There will be no kissing on today's show. Unless you like my disease, huh? Huh?
What disease is it? Hey, there's a gale storm over here, if you pardon the old...
A gale storm up there?
The wind is blowing up there.
Now, okay.
Oh.
Thank you.
That's a disease.
Hey, that's not bad.
That's my sanitary kiss for today.
Are you all quite ready?
Oh, yes.
Quite cold, but that's right.
Welcome back from the Robert
you.
Newhart
Whatever show.
Whatever
show that is, yeah.
Welcome back from Barnaby Jones. And now, let us say welcome to Mickey Betts and Puanani Kandek. Mickey Bettis. How much? You got $600, right? Mickey has won one game. She has $600, and that makes her very happy. She's being challenged by Puanani Kandek, who's got a great name. And she's had her first round question, had pretty good fortune with it, matched two of our celebrities. And you will have your first round question in a moment. Can we go to black? Because I'm going to sneeze. Pow! Hello there. Now, I will push this button with my magic finger, reveal the second half of the first round question. Mickey Bettis, this is all for you. Everybody plays, and here it is. A strange thing happened to Mr. Hyde. When he drank his potion, he didn't turn into Dr. Jekyll. Instead, he turned into Dr. Blank. That's what happened. Instead, he turned out. There's a very easy.
Oh, okay. Go ahead, once more.
Going to the bridge,
some of us don't have coal.
Some of them have. A strange thing happened to Mr. Hyde. When he drank his potion. He drank the potion. He didn't turn into Dr. Jekyll. Instead, he turned into Dr. Blank.
You know, I know the answer, and I can't think of his name.
Really? Shall I come up and you whisper in my ear? Give me a clue.
I can't think of that name.
Well, give me
a...
Stand up now. Stand up.
Spooky
all right, now wait a minute. Let me get the microphone far away. Watch it. Give me a wide shot so you see where my hands are at all times. Would you take that jelly
either.
Drop out of your mouth and talk plainer?
I can't remember.
Are you finished?
Yes, I'm finished. I just had dinner, but I haven't done this yet.
Don't be intimidated.
Don't be intimidated. Yeah. That's a hard one for my first day here. Well, what are you going to do? That's a hard one.
Yes. One more time?
No, I got it.
What?
I just wanted to tell you.
Yes, my dear.
Sweet Brett called me up. She asked me what I wanted for Christmas. And I said, the main thing I want is peace and harmony among the races. And you know what she gave me?
What?
A Tony Orlando and Dawn album.
Are you ready, Brett?
Yes, I am.
I'm gonna start. Ready or not, Brett?
Could you read all of the rest of the stuff from over there, honestly? Because I hate colds. Could just stay over there. Don't
You're
mingle
not
with
get
us.
Cold.
Give it to the contestants. They get money for this.
We're not gonna kiss on this
show. I just don't want you near me, honestly. Stay over there. You look lovely.
Mickey, listen to this. A strange thing to happen to Mr. Hyde. When he drank his potion, he didn't turn into Dr. Jekyll. Instead, he turned into Dr. Blank.
Dr. Welby?
Dr. Welby is very good. That's very good.
I wasn't close.
Well, now that's the first thing that popped into my mind when I read the question. What popped into your mind?
Well, I thought if he was very short, he could turn into Dr. Spock.
Very short drink.
All right.
I said Dr. Laos, or Dr. Laos, the spooky Emma movie that Tony Randall made. Remember where he played that funny doctor?
Dr. Laos, was that it? I do remember the movie.
I know that. Say the secret word.
I just want to see splashes from over here.
I just want to talk to Richard. I mean to Charles. How are you, Richard? You're going to get the flu right up here.
I hate it.
Yes.
Is that all over with now?
Yeah, the whole thing, right.
I chose a very unique answer.
Seek.
Who's Dr. C?
Hide and Seek.
At first, there was a stunned silence, and then when they realized how horrible it was, this group of lovely people gave you a resounding boo. Hello there, Lee.
I think that was marvelous, John.
When he drank his potion, he didn't turn to Dr. Jekyll. Instead, he turned into Dr.
Somebody really peppy, Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper. Richie's looking for the answer, Dr. Welby. How do you feel, Richard?
I feel just fine.
Good.
Who's looking for what?
She's looking for the answer. He turned into Dr. Welby, which I thought was a marvelous answer.
So do I, my dear.
Atta boy.
Well, I gotta tell you one thing, truly. I'm glad that I matched you, but this is the hippest answer of them all.
One right coming here. Up right now.
Here Read comes. Your question.
All right. A strange thing happened to Mr. Hyde. When he drank his potion, he did not turn into Dr. Jekyll. He turned into Dr.
Dr. Joyce Brothers.
So, in around one, score is 2-1 in favor of Pua Nani Kendeka. Now we push the button here, go to round two. Pua Nani Kendek will now make a selection. What do you say, Pua Nani?
I'll pick A.
You want A? Pua Nani want A. Yeah. Hey, listen, as Tonto put his ear to the ground and listened for hoofbeats, you know who Tonto is, don't you, Pua Nani?
Yes.
Yeah. As he put his ear to the ground and listened for hoofbeats, the Lone Ranger's horse blanked on his head. See how quickly they understand? Finished. What? Hey, that's new music. Hold everything. Do I understand from that thunderous ovation of the new music that you hated the old music?
Why is the new music? What if we've been canceled and we don't know it?
Yeah, what?
This is another show.
What?
We all just turned up.
Right.
Why is it Persian?
What do you say, Pua Nani? Ready, Pua Nani? Okay, here we go. As Tonto put his ear to the ground and listened for hoofbeats, the Lone Ranger's horse blanked on his head.
Tinkled
on his head. Pua Nani say.
Did she say what I thought she said? This is not the nighttime show. I said sat on his head.
Sat on his head, yeah.
But he was tinkling while
now
he was sitting. No.
We watch the tinkle. Bob Newhart show.
And we don't say tinkle on the Bob Newhart show.
And
we say wee wee.
Turn about.
Oh, really, we do.
Turnabout is fair play. Yes. And if you watch this show with even the most irregular degree of irregularity, you would know that you can say tinkle on this show.
All right, tinkle.
No. What I'm saying is watch this show
right.
More often.
Okay. While I'm tinkling, I'll watch it.
All right. What do you say?
Nothing.
I don't play. Romeo and Juliet are not playing this round.
They're not playing this round. Oh, they matched in the previous round. Okay. As he listened for hoofbeats, a Lone Ranger's horse tinkled on his head, according to Pua Nani Kendek.
What do you say, Lee?
I didn't. I had... No, I just went along with the norm.
Sat on his head.
Yes.
Now, Richard.
Normal to tinkle?
I did. You, sir.
Well, you and I are the best.
You,
yes.
The diseased one. Would you give us your answer?
Yes, I love Hawaiian. I've been there. I've never seen them tingling at all. Of course, I've never looked. I said sat. I'm
sat on his head. Aw.
Aw.
Aw. Give us a little tingle for Puanani King.
What's her name?
Puanani King.
That's a good answer. No, I said did the bad thing. Tinkle.
Did the bad thing. Tinkle. Okay. All right. We picked up another one. Score is now 3-1 in the middle of round two, and we'll come back to you in a moment or so. But now watch this. Here we are, just waiting for you. Now, at this moment, the score is 3-1 in favor of Puanani Kingdek. Now, Mickey Bettis, you must match 2 to stay in the game, 3 to win. Here we go. Everyone plays except Richard. Chester the Camel said, "Before a big date, I always blank my hump." Chester, the camel, is speaking. He said, "Before a big date, I always blank my hump." Chester the camel.
Good talk.
Chester the camel said, "Before a big date, I always blank my hump."
Cute, Stephen.
All right, we're waiting.
Hello, darling.
We're waiting for the slow one here.
Okay.
All right.
Darling.
Okay, Mickey Bettis. Chester the Camel said, "Before a big date, I always blank my hump."
Shave.
Shave my hump. Shave my hump. That's not bad. That's not bad. I didn't know they had hairy humps. Did you? Did you, Bill?
No, I didn't, but I, mine's kind of strange. I always brush my hump.
Brush my hump. Okay, yes.
Wasn't funny and it was wrong.
Yes, it was neat, though. It was a neat camel, wasn't it?
Yes.
What do you say, Brett?
I told you it was a lousy answer. I said to be all nice and slippery on top of his hump. I said he always polished it.
He's always polished his hump. Now, Charles, it's your turn.
It's obvious these people know nothing of the nature of humps. I said... deodorize.
Deodorize my hump. Now, Mickey, you must match Lee Meriwether and Fannie Flagg to stay in the game and achieve a tie. All right, Lee, it's up to you.
Well, Mickey and I are obviously the only ones who know how.
Really?
They do it.
I know how, but...
they must shave.
Shave! Okay, 3-2 score. Now, Miss Fannie Flagg, honey. Hello, honey.
Hello, honey. I'm starting off the new year in a bizarre way. I've matched Brett. I said polish.
Polish my hump, so that means you are not a king that wins the game. Congratulations. You stand by here for a moment or so. We talked to Mickey Bettis and wish you the best of things. We have a total of $600 for you, together with our best wishes for being with us here on Match Game 76. Mickey Bettis, goodbye, my dear. Okay. Here we are. She's gone. Now, we've got Puanani Kingdek here, who's going to have her first go at over $5,000. And to do that, are you ready?
Yes.
All right. I point out to her that we polled a recent studio audience, a bunch of normal people like you, and we got their best response to this, blank fork. Now, the answer that group gave most often, Puanani, is worth $500 if you match it. Now, if you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And the third gives you $100. Now, let's see how your ESP is here. Which celebrities do you want to call on are going to give you some terrific answers?
Richard.
The thing that Gene uses when he eats soup, knife and fork.
A knife and fork. you're going to get my disease for sure, I can tell that. And who?
And Brett.
Brett?
I have two. I don't know which one to take. I think I'm going to go with... salad fork.
Salad fork. Okay.
And Charles.
Charles?
When I was a boy, I worked on a farm for many years.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah.
And I chose pitchfork.
Pitchfork.
So you got pitchfork, salad fork, and knife and fork. Which one do you want?
Well, pitchfork is the one that I had picked, too.
You had picked that in your head. Okay, come on, honey. We hope it's up there. And we hope it's in the high position, but we'll begin as usual down in the low position and reveal the $100 response. Salad fork is Brett's answer.
You lied.
Now, let's see if pitchfork is under the $250 response. Knife and fork is Richard's answer. So far, everything is going along as planned here. This, if everything goes according to plan, should be pitchfork. All right, Earl, slide it. It is indeed. Congratulations. Boy. $290 now has $600. You got $600. And now you cool it for a moment or so. We got to do a little business with America. $290, we'll get back to you, but first, this.
Today's consolation prizes are an assortment of Sarah Coventry jewelry to buy from a friend at home. Stretch your wardrobe with the many looks of Sarah Coventry fashion jewelry. And a hair dryer and well balls and shampoo. Conditions your hair while you shampoo, leaves it looking healthy, shiny, and soft. Even repairs split ends. Well balls and shampoo. And from Amarok, the beautiful Monterey collection of match hardware designed to give your home a distinctive touch. Amarok, a leading name in total home decorative hardware. Al Jolson used to say, "You ain't heard nothing yet." But wait till Match Game 76 starring Gene Rayburn continues in a minute.
In the first part of the audience match here, Puanani has won $500. She has a total of $600 now. Now she's going to play for 10 times 500 or $5,000. Now to do that, Puanani, to collect that amount, you've got to match one celebrity exactly. Which one will it be?
Charles.
Charles, you get ready to write if you would please, sir. And don't be tense, Charles. Because the ESP was very good between the two of you last time.
I hope it's about the farming then.
Here it is. It's worth $5,000 now. Let's get those thought waves going between the two of you here now. Here it is. Blank collection. Blank collection. He's finished. Have you got thought waves you're transmitting to Charles, Puanani? All right, think real hard and give us the answer which you think will match his. In this case, blank collection.
Stamp.
Stamp collection. All right. Now, Charles, she says stamp collection will match her for $5,000. What do you say?
As we say in the island where yes. Poor Nanny and I come from.
Right.
I never said where the farm was. No, you have son, Puani? Son have collection of these, what you call stump? That is what I felt when I looked into volcano.
$5,600. Good for you. You ready to play another game?
Yes.
All right, let's ring on Wendy Wilczynski. Here's Wendy. Hello, Wendy. Okay, now you can climb aboard. You two ladies know each other, so we'll ask Wendy to tell us a little bit about herself. Would you please?
Yes, I would. I'm a medical assistant.
Yeah.
And my husband, Mark, is a law student, and I'm really excited to be here.
Okay, well, we're delighted to have you. Wendy, would you please make a selection here, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Everybody plays. New game. Hey, did you hear about the fundraising benefit for New York City? Let me tell you about it. People paid $100 a seat
To see the mayor eat blank. $100 a seat to see the mayor eat blank. All right, folks, step right up on this very stage for $100. You may view his honor, the mayor. All right, everybody ready over there? Charles, quickly. Fannie, you not finished yet, honey? All right, good. Now we're all set. Come over here to Wendy Wilchinski. You hear about the fundraising event for New York City? People paid $100 a seat to see the mayor eat blank.
Buildings? There's a lot of them in New York.
Eat buildings. She said eat buildings. That's, I guess she didn't see the newspapers. What'd you say, Bill?
Well, I thought just to keep the streets clean, you could eat his garbage.
Yeah, that's one.
Dirty garbage.
Kind of piled up. Brett, what'd you say?
No, we say in Maine, we say if you promise something, you don't deliver, you've got to eat crow.
Eat crow is very good, too. So we got two good answers so far. Charles?
What do you say before you eat?
Grace.
Gracie Mansion, where he lives.
Eat Gracie Mansion. What'd you say, Lee?
I thought the same as Bill. Piled up garbage.
Piled up garbage, because it did pile up there. Richard?
El Crojo.
El Crojo. And Fannie?
I thought he should eat President Ford's plan for New York.
Yeah. That's very good. So, your question will come along later, but right now, this is coming your way. Two. There it is. Two. Well, we got 20 seconds to say goodbye.
Bye.
Can I breathe on you a little bit?
No. Don't.
Come on, Richard. Kiss me.
No.
Just one little kiss is all I want, Richard.
Say goodnight, Gracie.
Goodnight, Gracie.
Goodnight, Gracie.
Join us next time for Match Game 76.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Title Tales next over most of these CBS stations. This program was edited for broadcast.